Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us, it's called time interest earned ratio. Now let's talk about this in a detailed format. You know, over here we have an example or a graph of Volvo AB times, and their interest, that is the earned ratio, is closely 15.83. I'm not going to take you directly, you know, what does this mean or how much times, what exactly is the interpretation. No, first let's understand a step by step what this ratio is all about. We'll get back to this and then we'll analyze that, you know, what Volvo's times interest earned is increasing every year and what does this 15.83 shows us. So let's begin on that. So first, what is the times interest earned ratio? What is this? Well, see, times interest earned ratio is basically, again, a solvency ratio, which measures the ability of the organization to pay its debt obligation. Also, it is known as, we can say that it is interest coverage ratio. The lenders commonly use it to ascertain if the borrower can take on the additional loan. The times interest ratio is calculated by dividing the earnings of the company before it pays interest by the interest expense. Or the ratio is division by simply earning before interest and tax to interest expense. So we note from the chart that saw over here of Volvo, if we just try and see, look at the analysis, we note that from the above chart of Volvo's time interest has been steadily increasing over the time. And this is a very good situation to be in due to the company's increasing capacity to pay interest. You can see from 2014 to 2017, and then it goes on and on. The graph is just going up, so it's really good. So analysts should consider a time series of the ratios. A single point ratio may not be very good measure, or it may include one-time revenue or earnings, but companies with consistent, if you see consistent ratio over a period of time, that's indicating, you know, it's a better position to service the debt. However, you know, the smaller company and startups which do not have consistent earning will have variable ratio. They will have a variable ratio over time. So thus, lenders do not prefer to give loans to such companies, and you know, these companies have a higher equity and they raise money from the private equity venture capital. That's VC. Let's understand this formula now. Let's get to the next step. That is the formula. The times interest earned formula is equal to EBIT divided by interest expense. This is the formula. So clearly the ratio gives how many times, you know, the interest can cover the interest expense to its pre-tax and pre-interest earnings. The banks and the financial lenders often look at various financial ratios to determine the solvency of the company and whether it will be able to service its debt before taking on more debt. So the banks look at the debt ratio, the D to E debt to equity ratio, and the times interest earned ratio. Often, you know, debt ratio and debt to equity ratio, if you see for this one, is a measure of the capital structure of the company, and it indicates the exposure of the company to debt financing relative to the assets or equity respectively. But however, you know, the times interest over here, this ratio measures if the company is earning enough to pay off its interest. Now, high times interest earned ratio is favorable. It is good. It's not bad. It is good. And as it indicates, the company is earning higher than it owes and will be able to service its obligation. Whereas, you know, if see for the lower values, it indicates the company may not be able to fulfill the obligations. So that may be the case. Now, you need to know that, you know, many analysts use EBITDA in the numerator instead of the EBIT, which I think, you know, absolutely fine if you use it consistently over the years. That's good. There's no problem in that. It's a good measure. It's a good driver. Thus, you know, the new ratio becomes, you know, the time interest earned ratio. If you just want to change over here instead of EBIT. Now, this is the extra knowledge, you know, I'm sharing with you that, you know, if instead of over here, if the companies are like airline companies, they have huge rentals, then you need to add over here R, that is the rentals, EBITDAR times interest coverage, you know, sometimes they take EBITDA also, or EBITDARM if they are paying fees. So it depends upon company to company, which industry in which they are operating. So this is done because, you know, depreciation, amortization expense are in the accounting, now not actual cash outflows. It doesn't go out from your pocket. So for the given period. So thus, removing such, what we can see here, if you remove such D&A over here, you know, it reflects better earning or capacity of the company to pay interest expense. Arguably, the depreciation and amortization expense indirectly relates to the what we call as the future business. It needs to buy fixed and intangible assets, and thus, you know, the funds may not be available for the payment of the interest expense. This was the formula. Now let us see the calculations on the same. Let's take an example here. Suppose that, let's say, you know, you have two companies. One is Alpha and another one is Beta in a similar industry. So the two companies have, you know, some data over here as below, like, you know, Alpha data and Beta value. Here the data of EBIT is given 15 million and 10 million. Interest expense 5 million, 7 million. So in this scenario, the company's Alpha is going to be EBIT divided by interest expense and control R, so 1.42. So in the above example, we can see, you know, the company Alpha has higher times interest earned ratio than the company Beta. And thus, relatively, company Alpha is better financial position than company Beta, and the lender will be more willing to give additional debt to Alpha than company to Beta. So the times to interest ratio of the company Beta is greater than 1, which indicates that it generates sufficient earning to cover more interest payments. Thus, you know, the lenders may look at the other factors. They may look at the other factors like, you know, debt ratio, debt to equity, industry standards to decide. So companies with the times interest ratio of, if you say, less than 1, are unable to service their debt. So they cannot meet their interest requirements from their earning, and they must dig into their reserves to pay off the obligations. Now I'll take you to the advantage part. Now, what is the advantage of this ratio? See, it is very easy to calculate. The times interest ratio is indicated or indication of solvency of the company. The ratio can be used as an absolute measure of the financial position. You know, the ratio can be used as a relative measure to company two or more companies. And the negative ratio indicates that the company is in serious financial troubles. Now, if you see for the disadvantage over here, although a good measure of solvency, the ratio has its disadvantage. You know, we'll have a look at the flaws and the, you know, the backdrops of calculating this ratio. The first thing is that, you know, the earning before interest tax used in the numerator in accounting figure, which may not be representative EBIT we are talking about, enough cash generated by the company. So the ratio could be, can be higher, it can be lower. It does not indicate the company has actual cash to pay the interest expense. That's a flaw. The amount of the interest expense used in denominator of the ratio is again an accounting measurement. So it may include like discount. You have interest expense to be paid. So to avoid such issues, it is advisable to use the interest rate on the face of the bonds. The ratio only considers the interest expense. It does not account for the principal payment. So the principal payment may be huge. It leads to the company to insolvency. But further, the company may be bankrupt or may have to refinance what we call as at the higher interest rates and unfavorable terms. So thus, while analyzing the solvency of the company, other ratios like debt and equity, debt ratio should also be considered. Let me give my final thoughts on this. See, times interest earned ratio measures the company's solvency and its ability to service its debt obligations. So this ratio is indicative of the number of times the earnings to the interest expense of the company. So higher the ratio is better, is the financial position of the company, and it is better candidate to raise more funds, I mean more debt. So a ratio of greater than 1 is favorable. However, lenders should not rely on the ratio alone to decide. Other factors and ratios like debt ratio, debt to equity, industry and economic condition should also be considered before lending.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.